Okay, let's continue. You may be asking, why are we duplicating this paragraph and giving it its different index in order to style it? Is there no other way we can do it faster? Okay, let's say if we have up to 30 paragraphs or 100 paragraphs in a document. How are we going to duplicate it up to 100 times and start changing the index? It's not going to be pain. So that's the question. You're going to do it. It's simple. You're going to do this using loop. We're going to solve this problem using loop. Okay. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to delete this. Just leave only one here. Then I'm going to use loop. We're going to use for loop to get it done. So you remember loop? When you were taught loop, you were told loop is a kind of a function or a conditional statement. Sorry, it's kind of a conditional statement, if. But the difference is that it continues to loop, it continues to repeat until a certain condition becomes wrong. As long as a condition is true, it continues to repeat, okay? But once the condition becomes false, the looping stops. So that is what we're going to look at. This time we're going to use for loop, okay? So how are you going to do that? You're going to just say for loop, for, okay, then you put variable, let's just say you call the variable I, which I for index, equals to 0, then we declare a variable first, okay, which is I, then equal to 0. You remember that the index starts from 0. That is why we are starting this, we give this I 0. Because the index started from 0. Okay, then the second option here is the condition. This is where you put the condition, okay? You have to say I less than paragraph dot rent paragraph. The paragraph is this paragraph, okay? Dot length. Dot length. What this means is that the whole of the paragraph, you know, this paragraph variable actually is used to get all the paragraphs in this HTML document. And if you watch, you have four of them. You get that? Good. So now when you say paragraph.length, you're saying all the paragraphs, okay? The number of these paragraphs, how many are there? That's what you're talking about, the number of the paragraphs. And you know there are four, but presently we have the I is 0. So what you're saying, that if you are just saying that if I, which is presently 0, is less than paragraph dot length, that is, you know, the length of the paragraphs we have right now is 4. So if it's less than paragraph dot length, let a particular statement keep repeating. As long as it continues to be less than 0, or rather less than 4, which is the number of the paragraphs we have in this HTML document, let a condition, or rather a statement, continue to repeat, okay? But as the moment it becomes this condition becomes false, let the code stop executing, okay? Now if we can run this way, this loop will continue infinitely. So we have to put a counter down here. We just say I prosperous. What this means is that first of all, I is zero, okay? Then when it gets to this place, it will add one. Plus plus means plus one, remember? It will add one to that zero and it becomes one. Okay, good. When it repeats the code down here, when it repeat, it will repeat the code down here. When it repeats it, it will come down here again. Okay, when it comes down, when it gets this to this place again, the paragraph, the I will become two. When it comes again, once it gets here again, the I will become three. It comes again, when it gets here, the I will become four. And then it will stop. Because once it becomes four, then it's no longer less than paragraph dot length. That means it's going to stop. Okay, so having done this, we have to come down here. We create query bracket. I have to carry this paragraph, this and put inside. You know, I dragged it. Good. Let me close up this a little bit to make it look more professional. Better. So this is a for loop we have, and this is what is going to change. Then one more thing we're going to do before we start running, we're going to remove this variable, because we already have a variable I here. So this one will go. Okay, now we have the paragraph. Then we'll come here now. We are going to put this I here, because we've given the value of I, which is zero. Just put I here. You are done. Okay, so what will now happen is that if it will loop, it will check if I, which is zero, is less than paragraph dot length, that's less than the number of paragraphs in the document. If it is, then it will add one to the number that it is zero, making it one. Okay, just it will loop first, then to add one, and loop again, add one, loop again, add one, okay? And when it adds one, remember, when it adds one, after looping, when it adds one to this place, this paragraph will become one. That's this I, the number will become one. Okay, that is to say it will affect the second paragraph. Then after the next loop, when it comes back again, this will become two. It affects the second paragraph. It continues that way, 3, 4, 5, 6, depending on the number of paragraphs you have. Okay, that's the idea. Now let's quickly run it. We go to HTML page, then click on run, then click on launching Chrome. And let's click on change style. Do you see? It affected all of them. So that is what the loop has solved for us. That is it. Thank you so much.